Little daughter, was no sense with me.
I did a show called African Jazz and Variety, and while doing this, we were performing at the Johannesburg City Hall, which was the first time
we were allowed
to perform in the city and to white audiences as black Africans. While we were there, an American came to South Africa. His name was Lionel Rogerson from New York. He came there to make a film. He wanted to make a music travelogue. He would film certain things that showed the life of the African in South Africa living under apartheid, which is segregation. And he smuggled those films out, and he asked me to sing in this film. I sang two songs.
She left in early 1959 to go to the Venice Film Festival. The government didn't know, but as soon as that film won, Miriam was immediately banned. But her mother used to bring Sibongile to Doke House to prepare for Bongile to go and join Miriam, who was already in New York by then and had big success.
This is the house where Miriam lived with her family. There was no wall. It was a four-roomed house. Like that one. It was an ordinary four-roomed house. I remember when I came, when Miriam left, and then she sent for Bongi. We took her away to the airport, and Umama Christina was very sad. She was really affected by Bongi's. I mean, she was affected by Miriam's, because, and especially when she learned that Miriam was never going to be allowed back into this country.
Goodbye, mother.
Of course, I remember. She played here December 1959. And, oh, le telefono. Can I answer the phone? Village Vanguard. For when? Next Sunday at 9 o'clock. Okay. May I have your last name? Okay. Thank you. A man made the movie Lionel Rogerson called Come Back Africa, which played in the neighborhood. And it was a beautiful movie. We all saw it. But in order for her to come to this country, she had to have a job and to work. And Lionel Rogerson came to my husband, Max Gordon, who had the Vanguard, who said, would you like to give the room to Miriam Makeba so she could perform? And my husband loved the movie and said, oh yes, absolutely. Miriam was a phenomena, you know, it's a salsa, and we're all doing clicking all night, click away. And then a gentleman came down among others to hear her, named Harry Belafonte, and he fell in love with her too. Well, Harry was much more powerful than we were, and so he whisked her away from Lionel Rogerson and my husband, Max Gordon. Took her away. If I were Miriam, I would have gone with Harry. I mean, he had a whole tour arranged for her. He promoted her. It's his culture as well. He made a big thing out of that.
Miriam became very successful, and I brought her out and introduced her to the West. It was through me and through Come Back Africa that she got her start, met Belafonte, became a great star in New York. Overnight, just incredible how fast, through Belafonte.
I want mainly. To make...
We have used constantly our platform in order to project new people.
I want to make
our power.
We picture, used
our,
my film.
Craft in order to set platforms for other artists to,
I
be able
want
to
make
project themselves, other black
picture.
Artists. So that despite the inequities, despite the contradictions within this society, it has not deterred us from a black consciousness. We have not left the community. I am physically removed from the community. I am spiritually committed to the community. As long as one black brother or sister anywhere in the world is in bondage, there is no freedom for me. I may have a certain material freedom, but spiritually, I am in the same darkness that all of us in front of themselves.
For her to meet Henri Belafonte, Sidney Poitier, Marlon Brando, when she was here, it's amazing. And it's something that everybody would be dreaming of meeting and doing. So it is just, I mean, it's everything was there for her. And she has such a pride in her own culture that even if she sings any jazz tune, you always hear South Africa in there.
In the last 3 years, I have made 2 trips around the world.
Yeah.
On both occasions, I was privileged to perform in most of the major capitals. One of these countries, I talked with and performed with many, many other artists. Some of them are wonderful, such as the artist you're about to see.
Makeba.
Young lady from South Africa, Miss Miriam Makeba.
Possibility for her to be able to feature us with herself in America, but it seemed as if Harry Belafonte and people like that were on the scene, and I was quite disappointed that even my dear Miriam had to allow that, because I would have thought, you know, she would have insisted that, no, look, these are the people I want to be, you know, to back me. But it was not possible.
Oh, wow! Ik kan van echtheid. Dat is dit. Pijnlijk, maar wel echt.
Go underground. Some 5,000 people have in recent months been put behind prison bars. Among those who have been jailed and detained or restricted are many of our prominent leaders, which include Nelson Mandela. My country has been turned into a huge prison. This, therefore, does not leave us with any option but to ask the United Nations to take positive action against the South African government, calling for a complete boycott on South Africa and especially the sending of arms by outside powers to South Africa. Thank you.
Thank you. Kan bij mij thuis een rotzootje zijn? Is het ook? Is meer. Dat was destijds.
Early morning, I think it was Saturday morning early. And I had just gotten home from the after hours joint. Anyway, I got there. That was that very same day, Saturday, I went for the audition. And Saruka happened to be one of the people auditioning. And
then wow, a mooi dit.
Saruka picks up the accordion. And he starts to play some, and I've never liked the accordion.
Yeah. I had no reason to, same here.
Until I heard this guy play. I said, oh wow, this is no circus. This is an orchestra, I'm sure, you know.
I made the audition on Monday. And I guess they called me back either the next day or something very relative to that. Within a 2-week period, I had a passport.
Mm-hmm.
Do you believe this?
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
And I was on my way to somewhere. I mean, we did quite a bit of this, so we get stuck in the mud, but she's trying to help. How to do this?
Mamma mia.